Hello, Skullgirls fans, and welcome to Skull Hearts at Dawn. I'm your host, ShadowFury333, as I practice and try to see what I actually learned from Northwest Majors. I was taught a lot, but the question, of course, what did I learn? Actually, I learned quite a lot. One of the biggest things I learned was basically anytime you make a mistake, just let it go, and if possible, try to just do something. Because if you do something, your opponent doesn't expect that you're going to do anything. They have to now react to what you did, and it's kind of weird and random. They didn't expect that. They expected a reset at specific points, but now you're just doing it at some random point. They don't know what to do, and they might end up blocking. It turns into a frame trap sometimes. Like, it actually did while I was practicing in casuals at NWM. I got a few times with frame traps from just throwing out an attack because, okay, I messed up. Do something. Oh, it's to kill Sage. Well, I'm going to be practicing my defense here, that's for sure. In case you don't know, for anyone who's not familiar with Skullgirls, to kill Sage, though I'm assuming this is actually to kill Sage, I don't know for sure, if this is actually to kill Sage, that is the best player in Skullgirls. Like, pretty much.
Gentlemen and ladies,
or one of the.
Time to fight.
Okay, let's. Yeah! Okay, so I don't really have any hope of winning this. Assuming this is actually to kill Sage and not someone just using their name to intimidate. Alright, get off me. Ah. I don't know. I'm not entirely sure. I'm curious if it's actually to kill Sage. Although I feel like I'm wasting my super meter here. Shoot. Good timing on the Rebel Fortune assist, Skull. That was well done. Ah. Ow. Hey, alright. Oh yeah, right, the other thing I learned was that if I want to do a counter, if I read that I'm going to be attacked, I should go for that. I should go for the Heavy Drill, because the Heavy Drill is actually invincible. And it doesn't cost meter to do. I pushed a button. Caught me pressing buttons. All right. No, I didn't get a chance to actually make a mistake. I got hit too many times. Like, I guess I did suboptimal things when I was attacking, but yeah. All right, who's this? Not sure who this is. I'm really kind of curious if that actually was to kill Sage. The ping didn't seem that high, and to kill Sage is in New York. So, I don't know. Alright, what do we have here? Solo Big Band!
Prevails.
Ooh.
Quiet! Now shut!
Okay. I was expecting that the Big Band would actually go for an aerial, a counter aerial thing, so. Okay. There we go. That might have actually been a good opportunity to do something random. I just didn't think. I didn't start to think about it. It's like, oh, yeah, I guess. Alright, let's just get this over with. There we go! There we go! That's what I wanted. I mean, that throw reset was not a typical reset point, so. I mean, I guess it's kind of typical. Whenever you land or get in the air, it's kind of a typical reset point, unless I hit them. Okay. Getting in the air was a bad idea. What's drilling? Oh, right, Drill's vulnerable to low attack, that's right. Okay, so can I do the thing I was trying to do before, which is this? Oops. Okay, I wanted a shadow out of that. Ah, okay, this is. Oh, it's not over! It's not over yet! That was a potential mistake. Like I said, drill is the better option there, but it worked. But yeah, doing that super there, the BFF super, on reversal. That's super risky, and that was actually a bit of a mistake. It worked out, but yeah, like, that was a frame away from not working. Like, that was a frame away from being blocked. So, that's the thing. that was a mistake I kept making. And basically it was Skarman just pointing out, hey, you know, you might want to use Drill and not BFF Super, because every single time you use BFF Super, I'm able to block it because I recover in time. Oh, nice. Oh, I wonder if, I gotta test that. If I can cancel on block. I can't remember if I can cancel Heavy Punch on block. Alright, there we go. There we go. Yay! Oh yeah, that's the other thing I want to practice is my shadow combos. Oops. I don't think they expected that. I don't know if they expected that or not, but I'm not sure. Ah! I was trying to reverse a level 3. Okay. There we go! I think I'm not gonna win with this alone, but that'll work. That was mild mistake, but I think it just threw them off. I don't know. I'm curious how they were thinking during that match. But man, I am glad I learned drills, not Drill Super, but special drills are a really useful thing. The light one is actually totally safe, apparently. And I mean, that's awesome. So, yeah, and then heavy and medium aren't as safe, but heavy's a great reversal because it's upper body invincible, which is good. Okay. Who is this actually? Because no one goes by that name. Someone's making a weird joke. That's another big band. A lot of people practicing their solo big bands today. Gentlemen, all right, they're probably assuming I'm going to go in the air. Oops. Hey, that was a mistake. Oops. That was meant to be a drill, not a shadow. Alright. Ooh, nice one there. Nice jump out of the throw. What? I was blocking. Ah, that was a proper combo. Alright. I just don't want to use BFF Super, but I feel like there are times to use it. This being one of them. I delayed too long. Darn it. Alright, there we go. Got something up. Hey! Fireballs everywhere! What? Okay, that was nobody error. I wanted to do this. Ha! That was meant to be a shadow, actually. Oh, nice. Ah, okay, they got me. That was a bad drill. Should've gone for a light drill there. Or just gone for jump fireball, maybe? For sad loser. I feel like I did a lot better than that I've done in any other game I've streamed, though. Like, despite the fact that I lost, I feel like I would've lost with not even getting a match a week ago. So I'm still pretty happy that I've improved somewhat. Oh, I gotta remember to do my shadow combo stuff. Hey, it's my old colors. Actually, one of my old team, my first team, or one of my first teams. I wonder if they're new or not. Well, they clearly know how to play Fortunes. Well, they kind of know how to play Fortunes combo. Ah! Yeah, they do. They know how to burst bait. Wow, okay. They're not new. They're gonna DHC this round? Oh, no, they're not. Ah! Darn it, I wanted a shadow. Surprise. Ah, that would have been better if it was a grab. Ah, darn it. There we go! Ah, no, I've lost this. Wow, I have not fought a fortune in a long time.
I barely
got it, too.
Now, message from propaganda minister.
Okay, I'm trying to think of too many things. I'm trying to think of doing all my shadow stuff that I need to practice. I mean, the thing is, I was trying to practice it for a while, and then I learned a safer, less timing-sensitive way of doing the main bread-and-butter combo that I like to do. So, I'm not sure if it's a spacing-sensitive. I think it's still spacing-sensitive, but it's less timing-sensitive. Which I've been using a lot more, so I haven't really focused on shadow combo, or the shadow reset loop thing, because I don't need it as much.
Time to wrestle like bear! Crush them!
Ah. That was a bad read. Okay, they're gonna try to burst bait right now. Ah, seriously, I got hit out of that? I gotta use light drill. Okay, light drill if I don't totally expect to be hit. Darn it, what am I doing? Who the heck is this person? I mean, they clearly know what they're doing, just know who they are. Well, that worked. Ah. No. What, seriously? Okay. If I weren't streaming, this is where I would take a break. Nope. Darn it. This is where I'd go into practice mode, but I can't because I'm on stream, so let's not then. Let's not even talk about it. Alright, Beowulf. That I'm a bit more familiar with. I guess that's true. Quick Match is a lot of solos. I'm curious how many people actually play these as solo characters, though. Oh, this is gonna be painful. Get a wire connection, please. What the? Darn it. I don't know what's happening anymore. What? Just get rid of this. Oh, I didn't get rid of the life. There we go. That works. I'm trying to set up something like the way the Milia works. Ow. This is so annoying. Why? Wireless connections. Why? Please never. Like, anyone's watching this, if you ever want to play Skullgirls, get on a wire connection. Otherwise, stuff like this will happen, and it's a pain in the butt for everybody. Like, this is symmetrically a pain in the butt, I'm sure. I'm fairly certain it's symmetrically a pain in the butt.
Time to fight!
Oh, what? Shoot. That's exactly what he wanted. There we go. Ah, not quite enough. Shoot. Ow. Stupid rollback. There we go. That was painful. What was the name? Looper Liberated. I will not play them again. That was remarkably painful. I am not going to do that again. Okay, is this the same person? It is not. It is actually the big band I was playing earlier. I wonder if they're practicing a different solo character. Yes, they are practicing Eliza now.
Elvis, Horace, I shouldn't.
Well, I fought a lot of Eliza last weekend.
Gentlemen,
so.
And ladies, is
see how this goes. Oops. Whenever I do that, I gotta make sure. Just try to do a shadow. Like, I don't remember to do that. Like, light shadow or light drill or something. Those are. Light drill's not as. It's safer, but it's less of a. Like, it's less of a blocking property for flame train trap potential to it. Ah. There we go. And that's what the advice is talking about. Stuff like that. There we go. Well, there's more things like throwing out that drill. Throwing out that drill is a really good thing to have done. Aw. Darn it. I wanted to do the... Ow. My thumb is getting sore. Anyone who's been watching my Dark Souls stuff should know that by now. I've actually, like, the episode that I released about fighting the Abyss Watchers and hurting my thumb in the process, that was yesterday. So I'm actually, I'm not in a huge amount of pain, but it's distracting me a lot, and it hurts. So it's not helping. Okay. Ah. Ow.
Boys, the limo.
Clap for sad loser.
Man, I'm not sure how much longer I'm going to be able to do this. Probably only for about 10 or minutes or so. More. Oh! Hey, someone here who apparently commentated a match at... Lightning Saber... Okay, Lightning Saber Bash. Commented... Oh! Okay, yes. Cool. Are you the guy who gave me the... Are you the person who gave me the Fuqua stuff video? Because if you are, thank you so much. That's super useful. I know I'm not using it right now, because the Shadow Loop stuff requires a lot more practice to get really into muscle memory. Gentlemen, but if that was you, thanks a ton. What the... Oh, whoops. Gotta pay attention. Be focused on the game. Like, as in, get Windows to actually be focused on the game. All right. Oh well. I can't totally outzone Peacock, but I can try. I tried to outzone the Robo Fortune at the end of the episode. That's actually not totally impossible. Nope. This is more of a... This is an assault Peacock. No, they got me in the loop. No! Whoops. Shoot. Okay, there we go. Let's get out of that. Get out of that corner by finishing the match. Ah, finishing the round at least. There we go. What the? Wrong way. I didn't even realize I did that. That was a bit of a mistake. That's the sort of thing I need to do weird improvisational stuff though for. That would have been the perfect time for a BFF. Like, the perfect time. Okay. I know how to get through this. I just am not doing it properly. I think it's... Which one you have to... There's one you have to... There's a specific one you have to push block. But I can't remember what it is. What? Ah, I'm moving too slowly. Taking my hands off the stick and trying to rub feeling back into my... Okay, it was you gave me the links. Thank you. I'm trying to rub feeling back into my armor. Trying to get either less or more blood flow. Not totally sure. I'm going to want to ice this thing again. Because like, I keep rubbing my arms. That's bad. I got to stop doing that. I don't know how many more matches I can do. I have actually gotten a bit more, did record some Dark Souls stuff before this stream too, so there's a couple episodes of backlog. I could like just not play tomorrow, which is probably what I should do because, like, really give my arm a chance to recover. Oops, that's out of the, that's just out. There we go. Right. Do I not have the meter to do that? I do have the meter to do that, what the heck? Yeah. They were not paying attention there. Not sure what they expected, but okay. Ah, that's throw range. Man, Peacock's got a weirdly large throw range. Ah, shoot. What the? Oh, is it only invincible startup? Oh, right, it's low invincible. It's low vulnerable, that's what it is. Ah. After second, of course, because that's the bomb. Actually, I gotta say, that one match, I can't remember who it even was against, but it was a match I played against, I think it was against Hot Salsa, actually. Against, no, it was a different person, but yeah. It was Eliza matches that I was playing, and, sorry, Robo Fortune. It was Mysterious J I was playing against. Actually, I was rooming with. Nice guy. Well, we both got hit. Oh no, only they got hit? Ah, I got the reaction on the bomb, yeah! Haha, redeem myself. But yeah, Mysterious J plays a really mean Robo Fortune. Like, I don't just mean they're really good at Robo Fortune. I mean, the way they play Robo Fortune is actually kind of rude. Not super rude, but they're very zoning focused. And so I did a lot of practice of playing Fuqua zoning against a dedicated zoner Robo Fortune. I think it was really good practice, actually, because it got me. Also, I was thinking Eliza because the other person I was playing against, I don't know if they have even an account on Skullheart, but they were playing Eliza. I think it was Eliza and... I think they also had a Fuqua, I'm not sure. But yeah, they were playing Eliza a lot, and I was... No, Eliza Philia, that's why, because they had Philia point. And so I thought, oh, Philia hates zoners. I remember when I played Philia, I hated fighting against zoners. So I'll just out-zone them until they ran out of patience. That was also good zoning practice. Because Rushdown characters really do not care much for zoners doing their thing. Especially when the zoner also focuses on cross-up Rushdown themselves. And I can get them in the corner and don't have to worry about having them knocked down. It's not like Amelia, actually. It's a bit more flexible than Amelia. Wow. They're really aggressive. Hey, they hit me! Of course, that means they're going to be doing stuff for the next 10 seconds without me having any input, but whatever. It's one thing I've noticed that universally, or just about universally, Skullgirls, like high-level Skullgirls players are super patient. Because you kind of have to be. Like, it's not a matter of... I don't know if it's that high-level Skullgirls play makes you patient. I kind of hope it does, because I need patience. Like, just as a general life skill. So I'm not sure if it's that it makes you patient, or that it selects for patient people. If it makes you patient, great. If it selects for patient people, I guess there's a ceiling to how far I can go, but I think it just makes you patient. My opponent there was not sufficiently patient. It's like I said with the Philia thing, I'm actually starting to get into the mindset that if I'm playing against a Rushdown character, I want to go zoning, because they're going to have a hard time with that. It's one of the things I'm trying to do, because I play solo Fuqua. Like, I dedicated solo. And Fuqua's really flexible. That's why I play her. But the thing is, flexibility comes at the cost that you need to make sure you're doing the right thing at the right time. Because you're not going to do one thing remarkably well, so remarkably well that there's some domain in which you're uncontested. Which is one of the reasons why Sarabella is considered a good solo character. I think Big Band's also considered a good solo character. And I wouldn't be surprised if Beowulf was considered a good solo character, because they just dominate, at least at the close range, and have other, like, Beowulf and Big Band are really good at mid-screen as well. Sarabella is pretty good at that, but Beowulf and Big Band are amazingly good. Hey, it's Don Hibiki! I roomed that. He got third place. This guy's good. I also roomed with him. Nice guy. Well, for one night. Nice guy. Also nice guy. Like, all my roommates were really nice people. I really enjoyed having those roommates. Time to fight. I also played like 20 matches against them offline, and they're about as scary as they are. And no, I also realized I had a lot of Robo Fortunes in my room. And Fuqua's too. They're not playing Fuqua now, but Don Hibiki has a mean Fuqua. Like, they have an awesome Fuqua. Oh, shoot. I thought I counter hit them. Apparently, I was the one that got counter hit. Okay, now one thing about Don Hibiki, they like to go for max damage, although it looks like I just missed a reset. Yeah. They really like to go for max damage on their combos, so I have to be careful to make sure I don't waste opportunities, because I'm going to need them. Oh, I can block that. Nope. Ah, I got hit. I don't think I have a way out of this. I don't know. It might be a throw. No, it's a throw reset coming up, I think. Nope, that's death. That's death. Because it's going to be DHC if I... Yeah. Okay. There's the DHC, actually. But yeah, that's not surprising. Now that I know who Don Hibiki is, because I've played against them online a fair amount before on these streams, but now that I know who they are, like, okay, I know who you are. I played you offline a bunch of times. I know you're really good at this game. I'm not going to feel too bad that I'm not doing super well. I'm not going to feel like I'm wasting my time, because, like, I've also gotten, like, in-person advice from them. That helps. Also, I got a bit of an attitude shift at NWM about wasting people's time, realizing that people at high level don't seem to think that I'm wasting their time playing with them. Like, people really didn't agree with the idea that I could possibly waste other people's time by playing with them, by practicing with them. So that was really nice of other people. Everyone's so nice in the Skullgirls community. Oh, maybe not everyone, but a lot of people are nice. Yeah, there's the Fuqua. So solo Fuqua. They're probably going to try to show me Fuqua things by using them themselves. Ah, and it'll be Shadow Thing here, and then... that was not the reset I expected. I can't remember what they did. Oh, what? Oh, okay, it's cross under resets that their plan is. Oh, right, they do that double jump all the time. Gotta remember that. Okay, so double jumps. I wanted an air one. Man, like, I think there's a delay before you can actually jump after doing that. What? I was doing the drill super, wasn't I? Okay, apparently not. I thought I had to drill after that counter. Like, what I'm trying to do is drill super and then jump. Yeah, I'm going to Combo Breaker. So if you're going to Combo Breaker, I'll be there. That's a month from now. That is the last weekend of May. But yeah, as I was saying, with what I'm trying to do, if I'm doing the counter drill, it cancels into drill super and knocks down. And what I'm trying to do is do that into a fireball. Like, drop a fireball. I don't think I have the time to do a fireball and a shadow. That doesn't seem to be the case. But if I can do fireball, I can at least lock them down a bit. And that's what I'm kind of wanting to do. Which I know sounds weird. It's like, why are you trying to play Fuqua like Milia? But I am. That's what I'm trying to do. Or at least have that option in my hat. Oops. Well, that was weird. I was kind of not even really sure what I was doing there. That was kind of a drunken boxing-y thing. Ah, I thought I had time. A drill would have been perfect, or H-drill would have been perfect there. What? Ah, low attack. Okay. H-drill would have been an ideal choice. Ah, when I finally get the cancel inputs right. It's not like it's that hard. It's just quarter circle forward is not that bad. Actually, I just realized against Big Band, BFF is actually fairly valuable. Like, they can't do anything about that, for one thing. Oops. Okay, that was a mistake. I should have gone for the reset. I'm not playing Guilty... I don't know why I'm trying to play, like, Guilty Gear. This is not Guilty Gear. Player two is best. I don't know why I'm trying to play, like, Guilty Gear. That's... I mean, like I said, I want to have that option, but I feel like I'm relying on it too. Okay, I'm practicing. I'm trying to figure out what I can get away with. I'm not so much relying on it as I am just trying to see, can I get away with this as an option? Is this even something worth pursuing as... some additional option besides just resets. I mean, in that particular case, I wasn't going to get lethal, and that was a case where I needed a reset. Like, I needed to reset and then possibly go for the drill super as lethal. I'll keep that in mind. Like, I'll have to remember that for the future. Yeah, I feel kind of bad I didn't get... Like, the Drill Sweeper from the ground, it feels like I can get away with a Fireball. I might be able to get with a Fireball or a Shadow. I just feel like the Fireball is a lockdown move. So it gives me a bit more time to position myself, whereas with the Shadow, like, if I read the right kind of Shadow, or if I do Light Shadow and they're not blocking low, it works. The other two Shadows might be a bit too slow. Or if they get super aggressive, it's like, oh, I'm gonna get back at them, and I do a medium Shadow and it just smacks them and I'm out of the way. That could work, potentially. I don't know. I feel like it's one of those things that's kind of risky. Like, more risky than I really want when I'm trying to go for knockdown, lockdown. Anyway. Okay, well, fine, whatever. If their connection's not too bad, then it's not gonna be that bad. Like, the problem is if the jitter is high, not if the thing's high.
Quit!
Alright. That was not what I wanted. I wanted to drill first, but... Oh, no. Alright, Servo kind of Nancy's owner. I'd be careful here. What? Ah, they threw my... Right, because I guess the diamond drop is... I don't have meter, that's why. I'm on the right, got it. I'm on the right. Oh, whoops. Okay. There we go! Hey, that actually worked too after a proper burst. Ah. Hey, I just realized something. I can power cancel some things that... It might actually confuse the sound effects. No. Nah, that's why I never do that. That's why I should never do that on reversal. I've learned that lesson. The drill would have been safer, would have gotten me out of the way of that. Ah. Well, at least that wasn't too bad ping-wise. Man.
Clap for sad loser.
I don't know. I probably shouldn't have been so close to the wall there. Hey, it's Maccabi. I guess it's how you pronounce the name. I'm not sure. Oh, this is one of the Big Band Beowulf players. All right, let's see what I do now. Pressing against a few big bands and one Beowulf. They're going to Syscall right out of the gate. No, they're not. Okay. I thought they would for some reason. Ah, very rapidly, though. Okay. Gotta figure out when... Ah! Thought I had the time there. What? Why am I not doing supers when I'm inputting supers? Okay, that was... a fortuitous mistake. Oh, right, it's... that's the wrong... wrong way of getting in. At least not after BFF. Ow. No, I still have a lot to learn before dealing with this enemy. Okay, well, I mean, that was bad time to practice the shadow combo. I forgot that the way the shadow combo works... Well, the way BFF works is that right after BFF, everything you do applies to IPS. So you actually have to be there. Wait, why is Kuda... Are you asking me to try Parasol? Are you asking me to try Parasol, or are you suggesting that to other people in the chat? Because Parasol is too clunky for my taste. Like, she moves too slowly for my taste, or too lopsidedly. I don't know. Gotta be honest, that's one of the things about Skullgirls. There aren't a lot of characters that I find whose movement I like. Even Fook was kind of on the edge, but she has enough... I like her flexibility enough that I can forgive the fact that she has no air dash. But her main movement is still pretty normal. Like, she's still relatively speedy. She just doesn't have an air dash, which is annoying, but I can manage. I don't know why you're suggesting I try Parasol, because I don't find Parasol fits my style. Like, I don't generally, as a rule, like charge characters. Okay, are you trying to zone me out? Really? Oops. What? Okay, well... Wait, no, seriously, what? You can throw during startup? Huh, okay. Or be thrown during startup, I mean.
Don't even try.
There we go. This is a weird way of setting up. Ah, crap, I dropped it.
Want a bandage?
Don't even try.
Ow.
I'm okay.
Open your eyes.
I want to save that meter for snapback. Nope. Darn it.
This is fun.
That's not going to work. That was a mistake. This, however, was not as much of a mistake, but I still only get snapback now. That's the problem. Well, kick in the face. I guess they're practicing their throws, which isn't doing them much good right now. Kick Shadow! Okay, I think that's a good place to stop.
Propaganda, Minister.
That was a weird match I played. It's like, I'm trying to see kind of what I can do with this. With this whole idea of just go with stuff. Don't focus on mistakes, just try stuff. I mean, that was a bit too low damage in that particular case, but, you know, I gotta get comfortable with knowing what all my normals are and how, like, I know what they are, but like, really internalizing what they are. And then from there, getting into something different, like getting into not just the standard B&B combos, but also if I'm in a situation where it's like, oh yeah, this move would work. I just do the move because I know it works because I've been practicing that move or all those various moves. And I know what my options are. But yeah, anyway, that is going to be it for me tonight. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed that. I did, actually. I actually did enjoy that. I do not feel frustrated right now. I feel mildly sore, but that's due to last night's Dark Souls recording thing. But that will probably heal up quickly enough. I'm otherwise fine. I'm actually happy. How about that? I'm actually feeling okay. Huh. Okay, well that's cool. I like feeling good. So I'm gonna keep feeling good. And you guys all feel good too, if possible. Or at least, I don't know. I want you guys to feel good too. Whoever's watching this. So, have a good night.